हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द पोस्टल सर्विसेज. पोस्टल सर्विसेज इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट इज़ वेरी एसेंशियल टू पास द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर एट वेरी स्पीडीली एंड विदाउट एनी इंटरप्शंस. एंड हियर इंडियन पोस्टल सर्विसेज इज़ वर्किंग मोर देन 150 ईयर्स. पोस्टल डिपार्टमेंट इज़ प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसिंग्स अदर देन द पोस्टल सर्विसेज लाइक मनी ऑर्डर, acceptance of various deposit through small saving plans, postal life insurance and so many. In India there are more than 150,000 post offices, from which 90% are set up at rural area. Here we are going to discuss the services offered by the postal department. You can see the services that are provided by the postal department: general post, registered post, parcel service, स्पीड पोस्ट, एक्सप्रेस पार्सल, मनी ऑर्डर, सेविंग सर्विस, रिकरिंग डिपॉजिट, मंथली इनकम स्कीम, टर्म डिपॉजिट, पोस्टल इंश्योरेंस, नेशनल सेविंग सर्टिफिकेट, किसान विकास पत्र, पब्लिक प्रोविडेंट फंड. स्टार्टिंग विद जनरल पोस्ट. सो जनरल पोस्ट इज दैट वी आर सेंडिंग अ लेटर्स एंड पोस्ट कार्ड टू द फॉर अ कम्युनिकेशन एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन. Next is registered post. Registered post is also delivered by the postal department, in which some charges you have to pay and which is more than general post communication. And if sender need a post of post requires a proof in a form of signature of the receivers. So if you want a proof that receiver receives or not, so signature can be there, but you have to pay some extra for that. Next is parcel services. So all products that have been that had been sent and received, except which are the prohibited by law, or you can say banned by the government, that cannot be sent from one place to another by the parcel service. Beside that, you can send any other product from one place to another. Insurance can be also taken, booking of parcels can be done. In that, valuable payable post service is also available. And what is that? So in that, a producer or a seller receive an order, okay, and then they send that to the postal department, and postal department send to the receiver, and receiver will make payment to the postal department, and postal department makes a payment to the producer, and for that commission will be charged by the postal department. Next is speed post. So what is speed post? Speed post is a guarantee to deliver any post or parcel within a stipulated time and a within decided place in India, and charges are higher for the speed post compared to the general post or parcel, and insurance can be taken. Next is express parcel. So here express parcel is more costlier than a speed post. So it is also for individual department. Individual can also utilize this, and business unit can also use this. Express parcel is sent very speedily within a prescribed time limit, and postal department send this either through air or any other fastest route, and fees are charged, or you can say charges are higher than the speed post. Next is saving services. Okay, so what is saving services? The postal department, just like bank offers to us, they offer a various schemes of savings to us. 5 years recurring deposit scheme, monthly income scheme, senior citizen certificate, public provident fund, Vikas Patra, Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana, etc. And saving account also can be open, and checkbook it also given, and nowadays ATM facility is also available. Next is money order. Money order is an arrangement to sending money from one place to another through the post office. For this, post office charges a commission, and the receiver of the money will have to sign the receipt which will be sent to the sender. And there are two nowadays there are another two types of money order is available, that is IMO and EMO. IMO means instant money order, in which from rupees 1000 to 50,000 can be sent any part of India within a day, okay, and for that you have to pay a commission. And when you are going to use this, a secret number will be secret number envelope is given to the sender, and that secret number the sender give to the receiver. So when receiver will receive the money or this IMO, he has to show that secret number and a photo ID. Okay, next is EMO. So EMO means when money can be sent through an EMO, in which web services or computer network is used to send the money, by which you can send rupees 1 to rupees 5,000, and which is which receiver receive within a 24 hours. Next is recurring deposit. Recurring deposit is by which account holder has to pay the amount that is decided by both the parties, and before the and they have to pay that to the pre-decided date to the post office, and at the end of 5 years, when the accounts gets mature, okay, your principal amount plus interest will be received by the account holder. And if you want to extend for it, it's for another 5 years, it can be possible. Next, post office. The duration of this saving certificate is for 5 to 10 years, and information of interest rate is decided priorly before investing, and at the end of 5 to 10 years the amount can be claimed after the fulfilling the formalities of post office. Next is postal insurance. So as we can see, employees can get insurance. The person who are working in central government, state government or any semi-government sector, they are eligible to get, and there are different policies are available, and the benefit of this that you have to pay a lowest premium and you can get maximum bonus by this. Next is Kisan Vikas Patra. So the Kisan Vikas Patra gets double investment after the 100 month, or you can say 8 year and 4 months. So person who are investing in KVP, that is Kisan Vikas Patra, so they, when they are investing, so after a maturity they will get whatever they had invested, double of that, and the amount is decided priorly, and after the maturity it can be claimed, and by fulfilling the formalities it can be withdrawn. Next is PPF, that is Public Provident Fund. So Provident Fund account can be also open in the post office, that is for 15 years. Minimum amount can be paid here, that is of 500 rupees per year, and after 15 years it can be extended also for another 5 years, and it cannot be closed before 15 years. So whatever amount you are investing in a PPF, that is a tax free, you didn't have to pay any kind of tax in the investing in PPF. And if in a case death happens of the account holder, then the nominee will get the invested amount.